Hello everyone, Professor Franz here, and today we're going to talk about sunk cost. By definition, a sunk cost is a cost committed or paid and cannot be retrieved. So regardless of your action, you cannot take the money back. Then we call that a sunk cost. Because you can't take the money back regardless of your action, therefore, a sunk cost should never affect your decision. Here is an example. So, suppose you go to a movie and you pay for a non-refundable ticket for $15. Now, after sitting in the movie for 30 minutes, you start to realize that movie is a bad movie. And you start to ask yourself, should I stay or should I go? Now, whether you stay or you go, you cannot take the $15 back anyways. And therefore, that $15 movie ticket entrance fee should not affect your decision. So you will choose to leave if you have better things to do. You will choose to stay if you don't have better things to do. But either way, you should not consider that movie ticket $15 because whatever you do, you can't take the money back anyways. And therefore, the ticket price $15 will be your sunk cost. Here is another example of a sunk cost. Suppose you purchase a t-shirt at the final sale and you spend $20 on that. There's no return, no exchange, it's a final sale. After you bring the t-shirt home, you realize that, hey, this t-shirt doesn't fit very well. Now, what do you do? Do you leave the t-shirt in your wardrobe to collect dust, knowing that you will never wear it again? Or do you donate it to Goodwill or give it to your cousin? Regardless of what you do, remember, you will not be able to get the $20 back because it's final sale. And therefore, whatever you choose to do, you should not consider that $20. We call that $20 you pay for the t-shirt a sunk cost. Now, coming back to our business problem. For a firm in the short run, fixed costs are also sunk costs. For example, insurance. You already signed a contract with your insurance company, so you have to pay for insurance whether you produce today or not. Similarly, you already signed a contract with your landlord to pay rent for a year, for example. So that's also a cost committed. You have to pay your rent whether you produce or not. Finally, let's assume that you took out a business loan, $5,000. You have to pay for interest whether you produce or not. So all these costs, insurance, rent, or interest payment, these are fixed costs. They are committed already. So they are also the sunk cost. In the short run, whether you produce or not, you should not consider this fixed cost because you cannot take it back. And therefore, fixed costs are sunk costs, and they should not affect your production decision in the short run.